EA Sports. It's in the game. Wow, he just took off on that one, and he might have just won the game for him.
This one teed up, and we are underway here at AT&T Stadium. Braxton Berrios now from his end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So now here comes the Jet offense as they get ready to take over. They'll be led out by their 6'4 quarterback from Western Kentucky by way of South Florida. It's Mike White. Three tight ends in the ballgame here on 1st and 10. Now Hall to start the drive, and he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. Well, let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. Three 3-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on fourth.
And this is intercepted. He was trying to get it to Davis. And the Cowboys are going to take possession of the football. That's kind of a double whammy. I mean, the interception on the opening drive, that's one thing. But to give them this field position, that's another.
Absolutely perfect start for this defense. They take the ball away on the opening possession. They know that their offense will get the ball to start the second half. They line them up in field goal position. And to me, they got a chance for a touchdown right here out of the gate.
Calling a gain of 4 on 1st, and that'll make it 2nd down. There's Prescott. Over the middle. Oh, he put it on the carpet, a fumble. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And he returns it up just shy of the 20 to the 19-yard line. And I guess we're back to square one. A rocky start here. A turnover followed by a turnover.
Not exactly what we expected going into the game, but I always wonder about the nerves and people starting, the emotions of the game. Sometimes it takes a little while for that to play out. Let's hope that that's taken care of now.
Hey. They'll start on the ground. Hall stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5.
If you're a coach, you'll absolutely take that run every time on first down because it really sets you up to go in a number of directions here on second.
Hall again on second down. And he'll be stopped up at the 26 after a gain of only a couple. When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot, he had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling.
So after the defense gets you the ball on a takeaway and a fumble recovery of their own, you've got to reward them, don't you? You've got to stay out on the field, give them a chance to rest, and how about doing it the way they did it, running the football and picking it up on third down.
They would not have wanted to go 3 and out, but they avoid that right there.
Yeah, they avoided the glares as they went back to the bench, didn't they?
Neville Gallimore showing off a bit on that nice stop. Now they contend with a 2nd and 12 after the loss. Here's Hall again. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. And hold on here, because on that last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up. So as the medical staff takes a look, we'll step aside. And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. White looks to throw. He finds Corey Davis. The 30. 10. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in big sky country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Second drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys. They had the fumble on the last drive, wound up leading to the opening touchdown. Now they'll try again here, 1st and 10. Prescott. Open man right side, it's Lamb. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. To throw again on 2nd down, Prescott. And this one's incomplete.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
Open man is Noah Brown. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 21 yards there on 3rd down.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
And he'll be taken down right around the 41-yard line. A good run there on 1st down, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 2. From the shotgun again to Elliott. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a 1st down.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
1st down, Prescott. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and have them staring at a 3rd and long, and that puts the defense in position to dictate to the offense.
To throw once more on 2nd and 10, Prescott. He's got his man, it's Gallup. And that's going to be another 1st down as the tackle made at the Jets 17-yard line. Give him 18 on the play.
This has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A Nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
The first down carry by Elliott. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going, and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. That's a way that the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
The yards may start getting a little tougher to come by down here near the goal line. That's good work defensively there on first down, holding them to a short gain.
Got his tight end. That's complete. That's Ferguson. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. So back-to-back plays, each get nothing. And now what we have here, a third and goal. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Cowboys in possession as they'll see what they can do on third and goal. Elliott. And he'll get him a bit closer as he's down to the 2-yard line. This defense bending but not breaking. It's a gain of 3. It's now fourth and goal.
This is a long drive offensively. Wouldn't you hate to end this with just 3 points?
Doesn't it feel like during a ball game you have certain narratives going on and there's certain drives that seem to take on just a bit more importance than others? This feels like one.
And he'll get in. Touchdown, Cowboys. Sean McKeon taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Cowboys' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. That touchdown run, it was just straight power on power on fourth and goal, and the offense won.
Yeah, let me just follow up with you, because we always talk about how the low man wins, who has the best leverage in the trenches. On that play, we saw who won that battle. But it's not just that. It takes a runner with some vision, too, to find exactly where the cracks are, exactly where the creases are, and punch it into the end zone.
Extra point by Moore. And good. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And this will be a touchback. Berrios deciding not to bring it out. And now out come the Jets.
So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent offer a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now, they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one. An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
It gets them a little over half of what they need, and now they're looking at a 3rd and 5. From the shotgun, here's White. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds. So a big call there that brings up 4. On is the punter man as he boots this one away. Officially just 27 yards there on the punt. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a 1st and 10.
Dallas offense set for this next drive.
That last drive, it was a good mix. Run, pass, run, pass. Defense on their toes.
And what really helps out in a big way is when you're doing the run, pass, mix, and everything's working, that means that they're guessing wrong every time on defense. They think you're going to pass when you run, and vice versa. I would continue that, and when they finally draw a bead on you, maybe you mix it up a little bit, a little play action, and throw the ball.
And will they maintain that balance? Time to find out. And he'll take it across midfield down into Jet territory. Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or 2 short here with 3rd down coming up.
They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And Elliott trying to work his way forward, but it looks like he did not make it. He needed two, he got one, and that's going to leave him with fourth down and a yard. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now. So as they take it over, we step aside. Running with Elliott. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. They only got a couple, but a couple's all that they needed as they convert on fourth. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. They go to Elliott again. DJ Reed, who played in college at Kansas State, made the tackle. Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Prescott now. Able to hit his target man. And he's going to get this down near the 25.
This was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Down to the 22-yard line. From the 22, Prescott. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
On third down, it's Prescott. Over the middle, complete. That's Brown. And they work this near the five. He'll be stopped at the six. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. Throwing. Prescott. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game. Well, that's not how you hope to draw it up there on first and goal, CD, by taking a sack like that.
Well, they tried to be aggressive, didn't they? They didn't want to try and work their way past the goal line. They wanted it right there on that play. Unfortunately, it backfired against them. Now they have to try and pick it up here moving forward.
They give them a dozen on the pitch and catch, but now they're up against a third and goal. Successful.
They certainly paid off the coach's confidence, didn't it? And how about the fact that they stayed with the ground game? Because a lot of times in that situation, partner, we see teams try and roll the quarterback down, give him one pass option, and treat it like a two-point conversion goal. In this case, they were able to put more power and get it done.
Touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. Taken at the goal line. And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15. The Jets going to take over now late in this first half. And with him trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together, maybe get into field goal range. Now White with a first down throw. And it's incomplete. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They've got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. To throw, White. They'll set up the screen for Hall. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. First down now, but the clock continues to move. The final shot before break. White. And he will find Davis. That's complete. So we have come to halftime here in Dallas with the Cowboys out in front. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Back to you guys in a bit. But first, we welcome everyone to our EA Sports Halftime Report. First up, though, let's take a look at the next-gen stats from that first half for the Jets. And I can imagine the halftime discussions are about how can we improve the running game. They have not had success so far, and it's reflected on the scoreboard. Meanwhile, for the Cowboys, they had a little bit more success on the ground than their opponents did, and that should set them up well for the second half to come.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three from the 10. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. The Cowboy offense set to go to begin this third quarter. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to. How did each play work? Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. Elliott going to get it again on second down. And space tough to come by there as he'll get maybe a yard to the 37.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, go to zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
So in Jet territory now, here's first and 10 at the 38. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And now a fumble. The ball's out.
Wow. That ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. Prescott to throw it. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets' 22-yard line. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here. On first and 10, Prescott. He finds his man complete. It's Ferguson. And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line. Throwing again on second down. Prescott. He finds his man. Complete. It's Lamb. And the Cowboys are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line.
Didn't they tell us in our meetings that they needed to account for him on each and every play?
You think a guy of his caliber? So how does a guy like him get that wide open?
That usually means there's a tire breakdown on what the coverage was. Everyone thought they were doing something, and they were supposed to be doing something else. But bottom line is, no matter what, you have to know where he is and cover him on every play.
They'll try again with Elliott, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott with his second touchdown of the night. And the Cowboys take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Marr on for the extra point. It's good, and it is now 21-7. The 10-play drive that time, and it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott. Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. And this will be a touchback. Berrios deciding not to bring it out. So here's the Jets offense now as they get ready for their first possession of the second half. Well, the opposition laid down the challenge, an opening drive touchdown here to start the second half. And Charles, now you feel like this group needs to get an answer because this all of a sudden is a two-score game.
Yeah, you're right about that. It was a small, manageable spread to overcome. A little bit more daunting now. I think you're exactly right. Pressure is on because you don't want them getting the ball back with a chance to really extend this lead out.
They'll go again with Hall. And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a third and one. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They'll run with Hall. Uh-oh, he is going nowhere as he is enveloped behind the line. They end up getting stuck twice after that 9-yard gain back on first down.
Scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Here's the Jets punter now as he'll punt it away for the second time. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Cowboys with a football. They'll be looking to tack onto their lead as we get set for the fourth. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. Well, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
And he loses the football a second time. And the Jets have recovered.
Partner, that was... I mean, they had control, had the football, and the defense had... In order to keep them in the game, that's exactly what they did.
And now that door ajar, two... So hold on here, not done in the fourth. Following the fumble recovery, White. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Now White. Gonna look deep for Wilson. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Give him big credit for his coverage right there, because when he saw the route break deep, he stayed in position to prevent a completion while avoiding any risk of a flag.
Here's White. And he's got a man, Corey Davis. And all the way in, touchdown, New York. Corey Davis, his second touchdown of the night. And the Jets have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Zuerlein connects on the extra point. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away.
This one taken just inside the 10.
A dangerous return man showing it here.
A solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. And now this offense comes back out onto the field.
Now, Charles, of course, you got to remember, last possession they fumbled. It led to a touchdown. One score game here. Got to be careful.
And this is where coaching and training really comes into play, doesn't it? What does everyone say after an error? Next play, move on, next drive. That man tries to come to the front. They've got to take care of business right here and act like the last series just didn't happen.
Prescott looks to throw on first. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
John Franklin Myers, the one in there to drop him.
That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. He'll end up getting five out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
Well, it certainly appears to me that the defensive guys are starting to look a little bit tired while he still has some fresh legs. Not the biggest gain we've seen on a scramble, but still, some positive yardage on a play that initially looked like a sure win for the defense.
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, C.J. Mosley.
And the Jets are going to take possession.
Football. A critical error there in a tight game of the fourth.
All you talk about is taking care of the football. And it's lead here in the fourth quarter. Turning it over, now the door is open for the opposition.
Just in general, when you're passing in the fourth quarter with a lead, no matter at what point, you gotta be super careful.
Gotta be careful, and sometimes you can be so careful that you end up running yourself into an error.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Now White. He's going to look deep for more. And this one dropped in the end zone. Oh, looked like a touchdown, but not to be. And now it's fourth down.
I think we're both wondering if we were going to see them try to push it deep downfield, facing a one possession deficit late. And they certainly didn't disappoint. They gave it an effort.
And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right, and this will stay at a 7-point game.
I don't care who you are. 60 yards is a very ambitious attempt. Hard to make even in practice in the best of conditions. And now, worst of all, you give the other guys the ball to start their drive at midfield.
Inside give to Elliott. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. On play action, Prescott. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down. Backed up here, tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first.
fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game.
So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset.
This is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. Open man, Lamb, it's complete.
And quickly, we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Up the middle, here's Elliott. And they'll work this down to the 15 for a pickup of four. Now the Jets going to use the second of their three timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Again, it's Elliott. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the five at the six. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Now Elliott. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. Second and goal from inside the five.
In a one-possession game, every single stop like that could be a difference maker.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Prescott to throw. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Disastrous outcome there on third and goal. They lose 9 yards on the sack.
These strong safeties, some people may not realize it. It's really like an extra linebacker, right?
It really is, because they're hybrids. Half linebacker, half defensive back. The linebacker in him on that play emerged.
And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
Well executed there offensively. Defense looked a little confused, but he found his receiver, and that went good for 6 points.
And the payoff we just saw there tells us how many times they ran this play in practice over the past few weeks, because they executed that flawlessly right here on game day when the situation arose.